Hello, I'm Ferd from Stalladratus, and in this video I am going to show you how to put on an N-type connector on SD400 cable. So I have a piece of SD400 cable here, or also known as LMR400 cable, and I have the various tools required to put a connector on. So I have a cable stripping tool here. This is a very good cable stripping tool. It gives a nice clean edge. I also have the stripping tool itself. This will pare back the outer skin and expose the center core. And finally, I have this crimping tool here, which will crimp on the connector. And finally, I have the connector itself here. There's the golden center pin here. So let's start. We take the cable, and I'm just gonna cut a nice clean end on the cable. That's that gone. So if we look at the end, we can see it's a nice smooth edge. So the first thing we do is we take our stripping tool, and I'm going to go with this end first, and I'm going to put the cable in like so, as far as it goes in. I then put a bit of force with my thumb here, and I turn it several times, maybe six times, until I can feel the blade cut through the plastic, and then I pop it out like that. So we can now see that we've exposed the center core of the cable. Then I use this little deburr tool here just to take the burr edge off the center core, and I just give that a few spins like that, like so, and you can see it smoothens off the edge nicely. Then I turn the tool and I use this end of the tool to take off the black plastic outer sheath. And I give it about maybe six turns like so, and you can until it goes no further. And then I remove it and I expose the braiding here. Now it's very important that we do not have a braid touching the center core, because that will produce a short. So that's very, very important. We need to inspect it like so. Next, I'm going to put the center pin on. I place it over like that, as far as it goes. I then use this crimp tool, and I'm going to crimp this connector on. And I crimp that on, and that's very strongly put on. Again, I check for braiding that would cross over. It looks clean to me. I then put this little piece here like so. And then I'm going to shove on the actual connector like this. I shove it on as far as it goes. And if I look, I can see the center pin comes up like so. If I put my finger on it, I want to be able to feel that center pin, which I can in this case. If that center pin is too far recessed in, then you're going to end up with an open on the cable, and we don't want that either. Finally, I push that piece up like that, and I'm going to crimp it on. And that's very strongly crimped on. I just give it another one just for good measure. And that cable, the test then is to give it to see if you can pull it off, and there's just no way that's coming off. That's all good. There's an end connector put on a cable. Now, what we need to do next is just test the cable to make sure we don't have any shorts or opens. A short can happen if a braid of metal crosses over from the outer to the inner core. That'll produce a short, and an open will happen if the center pin is too far inside the connector. We commonly see these errors, so we want to test for those. And we have a beacon tool. Stalladratus has a new test tool, which composes of two parts. A beacon tool, this will send a voltage down the cable. It also sends a frequency, a 1 GHz tone. So there's our beacon tool here. And this here is our new test tool. And it will receive the 3.3 volts. And it'll also give an estimate on the length of cable. So this is cable mode on our test tool, And we can see it says open at the moment because we don't have any cable connectors. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to now connect our cable through this tool. So let's connect it here. And connect the other end of the cable to our tool. And if we have a look over here, we can see it says OK. So our cable is OK, the continuity is good. There's no shorts, there's no opens, and it made an estimate of the length of cable. It says it's 0.8 meters, and to me it looks like 0.8 meters as well. So that's how you put an end connector on a LMR400 cable, and how you test the cable afterwards. Thanks for watching.